What's going on, guys? This is Biker Dave with the Honda GoldWing 1800. If you want to reset the main computer of your bike, if you've got maybe TPMS sensor issues or just funky issues and you want to reset the computer, basically rebooting it, here's what you do. You know, take your left cover off to expose the battery. You have to open your left saddlebag so that you can pull this cover off. You know, this guy here. Pull the cover off. No tools are required. Then disconnect the negative battery cable. Okay, completely disconnect it. And get a rag or something to cover the negative battery post. And you'll just need a 10 millimeter socket or wrench of some sort just to disconnect the negative right here. I've got a battery tender adapter there, so that's what that one is. And just disconnect it completely. Now, take a rag or something to cover that battery post, so there's no chance for the negative to touch it. Then, I need to expose the positive, and that's just this little pin down here. Just pull this off and feed this off here. There's your positive. Now what we're going to do, make sure that the negative post of the battery cannot be touched by accident. We're going to jump the negative that's disconnected over to the positive that's still connected. Nothing's going to happen. Just connect it right there. It's a good time to inspect your battery terminals too. In fact, this one has got a little bit of corrosion on it there, so it's a good time to clean that off. In fact, we'll go ahead and do that while we're here. You see a little bit of corrosion build up. If you can see that right there. Now, if you see that in there, see it's got a little bit of corrosion building up on there. That's not good, and it happens to some batteries. So let's get all that corrosion off of there. So first you can scrub the cable itself. Anyway, that's not what the purpose of this video was, but it just happens to be there, so we'll take care of it real quick. I take a middle metal bristle brush like this right here. You should have an assortment of these anyway in your toolbox, and just scrub this crap off of here. All right, and use your metal brush to clean off your battery cable ends on both the positive and negative. Just go ahead and clean them off real quick. Make sure that they're nice and shiny under there. You can also take some dielectric spray cleaner. Get this in any, auto parts store, whatever, and just clean off the battery posts and cable ends. Just clean them. Get all any kind of corrosion or rust or buildup, anything off of there. This is good to do on any vehicle from time to time. Just make sure there's nothing on there. You can also purchase a sort of lubricant that'll help that corrosion return again. Anyway, let's go back to what we were doing. So let's cover the post here. Still need to clean that a little bit. All right, we're putting our positive back on there. Make sure it's good and snug. Okay, now back to what we were doing. Now we're gonna jump this disconnected negative over to the positive. Okay. Nothing's gonna happen. It's not gonna zap you or anything. So just make sure it gets a good grip either on this bolt, like so. Okay, so once again, the negative is separated. And we're going to leave it like this for about 10 minutes. And that will quickly drain out the capacitors relating to your bike's computer. You do this the same thing for modern cars also. If you're trying to reset the computer, basically. If you've either done a major tune-up, or any other major maintenance involving spark plugs, you know, anything relating to spark, air, fuel, exhaust, O2 sensors, fuel injectors, things like that, you know, throttle bodies, any kind of major maintenance or cleaning or replacement of parts, you should do this anyway, no matter if it's car, bike, whatever. If it's, you know, electronic fuel injection, this is a good thing to do. So anyway, you let this sit for about 10 minutes. That does it as quick as possible. And then we'll reconnect everything and we'll show you what to do from there. It's real easy. All right, it's been about 10 minutes and we've reconnected the battery down there back to normal. All right, here's what you do. We're just going to turn the key to the on position first and let it sit for about a minute. So here we go. You'll hear, you know, the throttle body movement. You'll hear some fuel injection movement. You'll just hear a few things moving around down there. That's normal. Your throttle body opening will recalibrate, you know, to a stock setting. And let's just let everything sit for about a minute. All right, it's been a minute, so make sure the bike's in neutral and go ahead and crank her up. Let it idle for a few minutes. Actually, you'll notice it's changing idle a little bit. What's going on is the throttle body flap, you know, the butterfly is adjusting a little bit here and there, so you'll notice that the idle is not completely even just yet, and that's normal. So we're gonna let it do this for about 5 minutes or so. So you make sure that your garage door is open, that you've got proper ventilation, and just let it idle for a few minutes. Now, while it's idling, you know, your radio settings are all going to be reset, you know, to default. So you're going to have to reset your channels and that sort of thing. So it's a good time to do that while it's idling. Now what you want to wait for is, you notice the coolant fan has just kicked on and operating temperature is where it should be. So that's been, you know, roughly 5 minutes of idling. Now all you do is just go ride the bike normally. You can go ride it for a good long ride, but just ride it kind of gently and normally, you know, don't really hammer on the throttle or anything. Just ride it easily, and that'll also help the butterfly, the throttle, you know, just keep trimming and working itself perfectly, and that's pretty much it. That's something you do to any motor vehicle, especially with electronic, you know, fuel injection and a computer and that sort of thing. It's a common thing you can do to any vehicle, really. And that's that. Check out our channel for all kinds of other videos relating to cars, trucks, motorcycles, stuff around the house, outdoor equipment, tools and things, you know. So just scan through our channel. You'll find all kind of cool stuff that may help you in the future. And once again, this is the 2012 Honda Goldwing, but this will apply to pretty much any vehicle, quite honestly. And that's it. You'll have a great day. Make sure you Google Horsepower House. We're all over the internet, including eBay, Amazon, Facebook, two YouTube channels. So check us out. You'll have a great day. We'll see you later.